Welcome back to our next episode of Medicine Corner by Dr. D. Today, we will discuss sore throat, also known as pharyngitis. Most people will experience sore throat at some point in their life. So when is a sore throat just normal occurrence and when we should be concerned? How can we determine if sore throat is caused by virus or bacteria? What happens if you don't treat strep throat with antibiotics? Is it dangerous if your doc misses diagnosis of strep throat?
Hi, I'm Dr. D, and in this video, I will cover some less known but important causes of sore throat and provide insight whether there is a simple way to differentiate between viral and bacterial causes of sore throat without the use of laboratory tests. We will also talk in more depth about streptococcal infection and common misconceptions about testing and treatment of strep throat. I will also address why overtreating sore throat can be harmful and the myth surrounding the danger of missing diagnosis of strep throat.
So I think we should begin with the most common question when it comes to sore throat. How can we tell if we have strep throat?
It is difficult to differentiate between viral and streptococcal causes of sore throat without laboratory testing, as the clinical presentation is similar. Typically, 70 to 90% of sore throats are caused by viruses, while only 5 to 15% of children and 5 to 10% of adults have strep throat each year. Indicators that point us more towards viral causes of sore throat include symptoms like runny nose, cough, and hoarseness. So, do we need to test every person with sore throat for strep?
Answer to this question is no. Testing for strep is not necessary in most cases.
Criteria like age, symptoms, and risk factors can help categorize patients with sore throat and determine the likelihood of streptococcal pharyngitis. Generally, younger children and adolescents have a higher risk of streptococcal pharyngitis, but more sore throats in this group and in adults are still caused by viruses.
So let's talk more about the streptococcal infection.
Most people worry that if they have a strep and don't get the antibiotics to kill the bacteria, something bad will happen. In reality, most people with proven strep will recover normally, even without antibiotics. It is a common misconception that streptococcal pharyngitis must be treated with antibiotics or bad consequences will result, but it's still important to make the diagnosis and treat it with antibiotics if streptococcus is found to be the cause of the sore throat.
So are there any conditions that can present a sore throat but can actually be more serious?
The answer is yes, there are conditions that present as a sore throat but can be serious, such as epiglottitis, retropharyngeal abscess, or peritonsillar abscess. Some other conditions that can manifest as a sore throat include mononucleosis and COVID-19. Symptoms such as breathing difficulties, severe pain when swallowing, neck pain, or in general difficulty with swallowing, among others, can indicate a serious underlying condition. In all of these cases, it is important to seek medical attention for proper diagnosis and treatment.
Now let's come back to the two most common causes of sore throat, the viral sore throat and the strep. Are there any criteria that make healthcare providers suspect strep rather than viral sore throat?
Yes, there are four signs and symptoms known as the Centaur criteria used to diagnose strep throat in adults. They are
tonsillar exudate or pus on the tonsils, swollen and tender neck glands, absence of cough, and last but not least, fever or history of fever. These are the criteria that your healthcare provider will use to determine if a person with sore throat should be tested for streptococcal infection.
Score 0 to 1, which generally doesn't require a rapid strep test, but a score of 2 or above does. Score of 3 out of 4 generally is considered highly predictive of strep throat, but it is not perfect. Even with maximum score of 4, there is only 50-50% chance of having strep. So most sore throats are still viral.
If the central criteria is positive, a rapid strep test is done, and if it's positive, treatment with antibiotic is usually prescribed. So let's talk a bit more about rapid strep and throat culture, and what do the result mean?
When meet the central criteria, we do a rapid strep test.
This involves taking a swab of the throat and tonsils, and the results are usually available in 15 to 20 minutes. If the test is positive, the patient likely have strep and is treated usually with antibiotics. However, a negative result is not always definitive, so the provider may conduct a throat culture to confirm the results.
Depends on a patient's risk factor and center score.
To get the results of the throat culture, it takes usually 2 to 3 days.
Now, many people wonder, what is the significance of white exudate on tonsils?
Patients come to our emergency department concerned about white spots on their tonsils. A little white spot on a tonsil is not considered exudate, but rather a small white material that collects in a tonsil crypt. Exudate, however, refers to the white creamy substance covering the tonsils, which may or may not be related to the strep throat.
So why do we actually treat strep throat? Most people are aware that antibiotics are prescribed when streptococcal infection of the throat is diagnosed. But what happens if treatment is not received? Is it hazardous to have streptococcal infection without treatment? To answer this question, we have to understand that strep throat, which is caused by streptococcus bacteria, is a common illness that most people can recover from on their own without any medication. However, there is benefit to treating it with antibiotics, such as reducing symptoms and shortening the recovery time. The primary reason to treat strep throat with antibiotics is to prevent rheumatic fever, which is an autoimmune disease triggered by bacteria in some individuals. Statistics show that in developed countries, the risk of developing rheumatic fever is low, with only 0.4% of people with confirmed streptococcal infection developing the condition, which is roughly 1% in 200 diagnosed cases. Even though the symptoms of rheumatic fever, such as achy joints and rash, usually go away on their own, the bigger concern is the possibility of heart complications such as rheumatic heart disease and heart valve damage.
This occurs only in about 1 to 2% of those diagnosed with rheumatic fever, or approximately 1 person in 10,000 with confirmed streptococcal infection.
It is important to keep in mind that while treating strep throat with antibiotics can reduce symptoms and prevent some complications, there is always risk of side effects, especially with antibiotics like penicillin, which can be life-threatening. The reality is that if we treat everybody who presents with a sore throat with antibiotics, at some point we might end up killing more people with penicillin than preventing the complication of streptococcal pharyngitis. Therefore, it is crucial to only use antibiotics when indicated and not prescribe them for every case of sore throat.
Trying to drive this point home because some patients get quite unhappy when their healthcare provider does not prescribe them antibiotics to treat their sore throat.
In our next video, we will cover both natural and Western medicine treatment options for sore throat. In conclusion, while pharyngitis is a common condition, it is important to understand the underlying causes and any serious conditions that may present as a sore throat. In most cases, antibiotics aren't necessary for recovery, but it's important to seek medical condition if more serious condition is suspected.
We hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give us thumbs up and we will see you in our next video.